Great Galactic Ghostbusters. Can AI really see our thoughts? Do we need to be scared? Remember that episode of Star Trek where Spock could read minds with a touch? Well, beam me up, because science fiction is getting real. We're on the verge of a mind-reading revolution. No, I'm not talking about your kooky aunt who claims to predict lottery numbers. This is about artificial intelligence, the kind that makes your smartphone smarter than a bag of hammers. Scientists are training AI to peek inside our brains. They can actually reconstruct images from our thoughts. It's like having a window into your imagination, except the window is a computer screen, and the view is, well, kind of blurry right now. But hey, it's early days. This tech is still in its infancy. Think of it as a baby taking its first steps. It's wobbly, it's messy, but boy, is it exciting. This isn't just about satisfying our sci-fi fantasies, though. It has the potential to revolutionize everything from medicine to entertainment. But before we get ahead of ourselves, let's take a closer look at what's really going on inside those AI-powered brains. Japan, Singapore, Meta. Oh my, a global brain scanning party. So, who are these mind-reading masterminds? Let's start with Japan, a country that loves its robots and its cutting-edge tech. Researchers there have used AI to reconstruct images from brain activity with surprising accuracy. They're basically turning thoughts into blurry Polaroids. Then there's Singapore, another tech-savvy nation, hot on Japan's heels. They're using AI to understand brain signals related to things like attention and memory. This could be a game-changer for folks with cognitive disorders. And let's not forget about Meta, the company that wants to be in your face. And now, apparently, in your brain too. They're working on technology that can translate your thoughts into text. Imagine writing an email just by thinking it. This is a global effort, folks. Scientists and engineers worldwide are racing to unlock the secrets of the human brain, and they're using AI as their ultimate decoder ring. fMRI, MEG, stable diffusion, decoding the jargon jungle. Now, this is all very fascinating, but can you explain it in a way that doesn't make my head spin faster than a pulsar? Don't worry, I've got you covered. Let's talk about the science behind this mind-bending technology. Imagine your brain as a bustling city. Thoughts are like cars zipping around, creating a symphony of electrical and chemical signals. Scientists use fancy brain scanners like fMRI and MEG to detect these signals. That's where AI comes in, acting like a super sleuth detective. It analyzes these signals and tries to figure out what's going on in your noggin. One of the tools it uses is something called stable diffusion. It's like a reverse CSI episode. Instead of using evidence to reconstruct a crime scene, AI uses brain activity to reconstruct the images in your mind. It's still early days, and the images AI produces are often fuzzy and abstract. But the more data we feed these AI algorithms, the better they get at deciphering our brain's cryptic messages. From mind to movie. Imagine the possibilities. And the popcorn. So, what can we do with this mind-blowing technology? Buckle up, because the possibilities are endless. Imagine a world where people with locked-in syndrome can communicate their thoughts and feelings just by thinking them. Or a world where stroke victims can relearn how to speak and move by retraining their brains. This technology could be a game-changer for patients with neurological disorders. But wait, there's more. How about diving into virtual reality worlds controlled by your thoughts? No more clunky headsets or controllers. Your mind is the ultimate joystick. And forget about boring old movies. How about experiencing films that adapt to your every emotion? Talk about interactive entertainment. This technology could even revolutionize how we learn, create art, and understand the universe within our skulls. It's like opening up a new frontier, not in space, but in the vast, uncharted territory of the human mind. The ethics of thought reading. Hold on to your hats and your privacy. Now, before we all get carried away with our telepathic daydreams, let's pause for a reality check. This technology raises some serious ethical concerns. First and foremost, there's the issue of privacy. Our thoughts are our most private spaces. Do we really want machines snooping around in there? Imagine a world where your boss can read your mind during a job interview, or where advertisers can target you based on your deepest desires. It's enough to give anyone the creeps. Then there's the question of consent. Who gets to decide whether our thoughts are accessed and used? What about children or people who can't give consent for themselves? These are thorny ethical dilemmas that we need to grapple with sooner rather than later. And finally, there's the societal impact. How will this technology change our relationships with each other and with technology? Will it create new forms of inequality or erode our sense of self? These are big questions, folks, and we need to start thinking about the answers now. The future of mind reading. Brace yourselves. So, there you have it. Mind reading AI. It's a technology with the potential to change the world, for better or for worse. It's like a powerful new tool, and like any tool, it can be used for good or for evil. It all depends on us. We need to proceed with caution, ensuring that this technology is developed and used responsibly. We need to have open and honest conversations about the ethical implications, and we need to establish clear guidelines and regulations to prevent misuse. The future is coming, whether we're ready for it or not. So let's embrace the possibilities while staying mindful of the risks. After all, the human mind is a precious and powerful thing. Let's make sure we treat it with the respect it deserves. Subscribe now and join our mind reading club. No tinfoil hats required. Don't worry, we promise not to read your mind when you hit that subscribe button, or will we?